Do you find a day at the beach relaxing? Just picture it. Smooth sand, the peaceful sound of waves, seagulls flying. But what if I told you that these calm beach waves could turn into your worst nightmare? Can you imagine waves taller than city buildings, traveling faster than a race car, and stretching across entire oceans? There's a special word for this nightmare come to life: tsunami. But don't worry, we're here to guide you through everything you need to know about tsunamis. From how they form to how we can stay safe when they come crashing towards our shores. We've gathered some naturally wonderful things for you to explore on the Socratica Foundation website. Find more smart, fun videos and downloads, fact-filled games and activities that help you learn and remember. Find the link below. First things first, what is a tsunami? And how is it different from just a really large wave? A tsunami is a series of powerful ocean waves. These waves are triggered by something big happening underwater, like an earthquake shaking the ocean floor, a volcano erupting under the sea, or even a huge chunk of land sliding into the water. When these events happen, they push and pull the ocean water, creating massive waves that travel across the ocean at lightning speed. Tsunami might seem like a strange word, hard to spell, and even a little hard to say. But did you know that when you say tsunami, you're speaking Japanese? In the Japanese language, tsu means harbor and nami means wave. So when you put them together, tsunami literally means harbor wave. Why harbor waves? They get this name because from time to time, a giant wave would crash in and destroy their harbors. Sad, but true. Tsunamis are big, but they're also really fast. They don't waste any time getting around. In fact, tsunamis can race across the ocean as fast as a jet plane flies. Imagine zooming across North America in just a few hours. That's how fast tsunamis can travel. Speeds can reach over 800 kilometers per hour, which is a lot faster than cars on a highway. This lightning-fast pace is what makes tsunamis so dangerous, as they can strike coastal areas with little warning, catching people off guard. Now, something you may not expect about tsunamis is their wavelengths. Wavelength is a handy word to learn because you can use it to describe all sorts of waves. Waves at the beach, sound waves, light waves. It's the distance between the peaks of the waves. For tsunamis, these wavelengths can be super long. We're talking anywhere from 150 to 1,000 kilometers long. But here's the thing. Even though tsunamis have these long wavelengths, they're not very noticeable out in the deep ocean. In fact, they can be just a few inches high. That's because the water is so deep that the waves don't have much height. As the waves move away from deep waters and closer to shallower coastal waters, the waves get bigger and bigger, forming what we know as a tsunami. So even though tsunamis are powerful, they can slip by unnoticed until they reach shallow waters near the coast. Now, we keep using the word wave, and you might picture the fun little waves we splash in at the beach. But don't be fooled. Tsunamis don't play by the same rules as regular waves. You see, normal waves have ups and downs, like a roller coaster ride, and eventually crash into the shore. But tsunamis? They're more like a giant wall of water charging ahead, pushing everything in its path. When a tsunami reaches the shore, it doesn't just crash and retreat like regular waves do. Instead, it rushes forward with a powerful surge, flooding inland areas like a super-sized bathtub overflowing. When tsunamis do reach land, they can get very, very big and tower over everything in their path. These mega waves can reach heights of over 30 meters. That's taller than a 10-story building. Just imagine looking up and seeing a wall of water much taller than you are. The size of a tsunami depends on a lot of things, like if it was started by an earthquake, how big was that earthquake, and how far it traveled across the ocean. But generally, as a rule of thumb, tsunamis are way too big to tangle with. Now that we know what tsunamis are and how big they get, it's time to learn about where they can be found. Tsunamis can occur anywhere, in any ocean, but they're actually much more likely to occur in certain parts of the world. One popular spot is called the Ring of Fire, which is an area that surrounds the Pacific Ocean. It's a hotbed of natural wonders, with lots of earthquakes and volcanoes rattling and rumbling and spewing all the time. And you know what happens when the Earth starts shaking underwater, or a volcano decides to blow its top? You guessed it, tsunamis. Want to take home a souvenir of these natural wonders? Visit our website for smart, fun posters that are funny and fact-filled. Find the link below. Just like how your body gives you signs when you're feeling sick, the Earth can give us warning signs when a tsunami is on its way. First up, if you notice the ocean suddenly pulling back from the shoreline, like it's getting sucked away, that's a big red flag. It's like the ocean is taking a deep breath before unleashing a big wave. Next, if the ground starts shaking like crazy, especially if there's an earthquake near the ocean, that's another sign to watch out for. Earthquakes can give birth to tsunamis, so it's like the Earth's way of saying, hey, get ready. And lastly, if you hear a really loud roaring sound coming from the ocean, almost like a freight train, that's Mother Nature shouting, run, tsunami's coming. So if you ever see, feel, or hear any of these warning signs, make sure to take them seriously and head to higher ground ASAP. Just like how we have fire alarms and emergency drills at school, coastal communities and countries have their own special way of staying safe from tsunamis. They've got a whole bunch of tools in their safety box, like sirens, buoys, and special communication systems. Picture this. If a tsunami is on the way, these clever systems start buzzing and beeping. Kind of like a superhero signal in the sky. Sirens wail, buoys bob up and down in the water to track the tsunami's movements, and messages go out loud and clear to everyone nearby. It's like a giant safety net, helping to keep people out of harm's way. With enough warning, we can get people out of the way of a tsunami, but once it gets going, there's no way to stop its destructive path. These mega waves have left their mark all throughout history. Two really big tsunamis you might have heard about are the 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami and the 2011 Tohoku tsunami in Japan. The 2004 Indian Ocean tsunami was caused by an extremely powerful underwater earthquake and sent 30-meter-high waves through Indonesia. Similarly, the Tohoku tsunami was triggered by an underwater earthquake that led to tsunami waves of up to 40 meters tall. Yikes. These events show just how powerful and unpredictable tsunamis can be, and why it's super important to be prepared and stay safe if one ever comes our way. While the enormous size and impact of tsunamis should be treated with extreme respect and awareness of the dangers involved, we hope it also inspires a moment of awe that our planet is capable of creating such extraordinary natural wonders. Now we can say we know what tsunamis are about. From how they're born deep beneath the ocean surface to how they can cause widespread destruction when they reach the shore. But fear not, armed with knowledge about warning signs and the behavior of tsunamis, we can all be better prepared to stay safe if one ever comes our way. So remember to keep your eyes and ears open, stay informed, and know where to go if a tsunami ever decides to make an appearance. Now it's time to watch another great video from Socratica Kids. You get to pick. And don't forget to check out our website with smart, fun extras we made just for you, linked below. Did you know that these videos are made possible by our donors? The Socratica Foundation is committed to making free educational resources for kids. Donate today.